Is it too late to launch an app this year? Is the app store too crowded? Well, in this video, I want to share the 7-step framework to help you build and launch your app this year. This is going to be a high-level overview video. So if you're planning to do this as a side hustle or go all in, this is going to be a helpful video. So stick around till the end of this video. And hey, if you're just meeting out, my name is R. Singh, and I'm a growth strategist for entrepreneurs, and I help you launch and scale your business using mobile apps. And if you're watching this on YouTube and haven't subscribed yet, consider subscribing, because I often put out time-based opportunities and giveaways. So if you're not tuned in on time, you might miss out on some of the good stuff. And you know what? Let's just go someplace more private so that we can dive into this right now. All right, let's get to this right now. So is it too late to launch an app this year? The short answer is no. I agree the app market is too crowded. It's insanely competitive. There are around 3.8 million apps on the Play Store. There are around 2 million apps on the App Store. It is a lot of competition, but that's also a good sign. The app market has been growing 30% year on year, and apps are projected to bound around $190 billion over the next few years. That, my friend, is a huge opportunity. So let's get into our step-by-step process on how to launch an app startup. Step number one, the app idea. An app, or any business for that matter, starts with an idea. If you already have an app idea, that is great. Just make sure that you're solving an actual pain point for your target audience. Now, if you don't have an idea, take inspiration by playing around with other tons of apps on Play Store and App Store. Check out the recent news, tech blogs, and see what's going on in the app space around you and around the world, and take inspiration from that. But you should have a clear idea of what is it that you're going to do before you start taking any action. However, in most of the circumstances, you typically pivot along the way. So you can start off with one of the ideas and see how the market is reacting, what is the traction, and then pivot and change your idea, modify your idea based on the response from the market, and then keep evolving accordingly. I'll not spend too much time on this topic in this video, but I'll definitely create another video on how to come up with an app idea. But the questions that you should be asking yourself are, what exactly do you want your app to do? What problem is it going to solve? All right, the step number two is market research. Ideas are a dime a dozen. The tough part is turning your idea into a reality. You know, sometimes people do not give importance to market research because they think that their app is gonna be a hit in the market and it's immediately gonna generate a lot of ROI, or probably they're too confident about their idea. On the opposite side, I speak with a lot of people who are stuck in the research loop. They have an awesome idea, they do the research, and I speak with some of them and they say that they've spent time researching on this idea for 2 years, 1 year, 6 months, and they never take an action. They get stuck into this analysis paralysis, and I think that also deserves a separate video so that you can start taking an action and get your app in the hands of your customers as soon as possible. Okay, so this is important, right? You do want to do the research, but you don't want to get stuck into this research loop, because the only thing that you get out of it is going to be the regret. And you know how that plays out? You come up with a great idea, you do the research, you spend a lot of time on it, you're super pumped, you put it on the back burner, somebody else launches it, and you hang out with your friends, and then you start cribbing about how you came up with this idea first, but did nothing. You know who gives a shit about that? Nobody. Sorry about that sudden rant, but I get it. You know, the market is competitive and the investment is big, considering both your time and money. However, if you put in the effort with a systematic approach, things will be a lot easier and you'll have higher chances to succeed. The questions that you should be asking yourself are, who is your app for? How will it simplify their life? Who are your competitors? What are they offering? What can you do better? And if you can answer some of these questions, then you should be okay to move on to the next step. All right, step number three, validate your idea. All right, so once you've identified who this app is for, then it's time to get in touch with your target audience. Try to break and challenge your own idea. The questions you should be asking are, why would people use your app? Why would your idea not work? What value are you bringing to the users? Entrepreneurs have a tendency to get stuck in this idea lock, and if you're the only one who thinks that the idea is awesome, there is definitely some problem. If you will not validate your idea, it might just fall flat. All right, this brings us to the step number 4, which is creating a prototype. You should be clear on how you want your users to interact with your app. Sketch a rough wireframe on a paper or use some tools, but try to depict the overall map of your app. This will definitely help the designers and the developers to understand and be at the same page with your vision, and it'll help come up with a better user experience. You can have a design-based prototype, or you can actually get an MVP, a minimum viable product. The benefit of both is to determine whether others would really use your product or not. You know, choose the right platform and find the right developers. You can find the developers online, or you can actually go offline and have meetups and connect with people there. The choice is definitely yours, but choose the development team very, very carefully. Now, once you have the MVP, test it and have others test it as well. If this is something that you would use, awesome, launch it. If this turns out to be something that you would never use and that's the similar feedback and a pattern that you see in the feedback from your friends, then just go ahead and scrap the idea and move on to the next one. All right, the step number 5, the monetization strategy. A lot of people skip this step completely, and if you skip this step, you may not be able to monetize your app. You don't want to do it from the very beginning, but you should have an idea and you should have a plan so that you can monetize your app at a later stage. Because if you want to be a step ahead of your competition, then you need to have the monetization strategy baked into your user experience from day one. There are a lot of revenue models to choose from, starting anywhere from freemium, paid, in-app subscription, ads, sponsored content, and so much more. Mix and match and see what works best for you and define a strategy from day one. All right, so this brings us to step number 6, launch quick, but launch small. What do I mean by that? Speed is greater than perfection, my friends. Don't flood your app with tons of features that nobody's gonna use. Instead, launch an MVP, a minimum viable product. Entrepreneurs and product owners typically love perfection, but the market doesn't really care about it. Don't go over the top with your B plan. In fact, don't do it at all. Just plan your next 4 to 6 months. The market changes so quickly that you wouldn't really have plan to execute your 2-year B plan. Your role is to put your product in the hands of the customers as soon as possible, gather some feedback, fix the bugs if you find any, fix the user interface glitches, and then keep improving your app over the incremental updates. Stay flexible and pivot if the market demands it. All right, so this brings us to step number 7. Be patient and be in it for the long run. If you've made it so far in your app journey, awesome, kudos to you. It's time to market your app, but be patient. Great work takes time. Launching your app will take a lot of time, energy, and self-discipline. Great products were not built overnight. If you want to build something substantial, then be in it for the long run, because you can't accelerate quality. In reality, there is no overnight success. It's only a sequence of failures and hard work that leads to success. Let me just quickly summarize it for you guys. Step number 1 is coming up with an app idea. Step number 2 is doing the market research, but making sure that you do not get stuck into the research. Step number 3 is to validate your idea, talk to your target audience, get some feedback, make some changes, and then move on. Step number 4 is to creating a prototype, finding the right team, being on the same page, coming up with the sketches, and then an MVP. Step number 5 is to make sure that you have a monetization strategy from day one, because you want to outcompete your competitors. Step number 6 is launching quick and launching small. Do not overload your app with tons of features. Instead, find the core features and then quickly go out there and launch that app. Step number 7 is being patient. Be in it for the long run. Do the hard work, be smart, pivot, make changes, listen to your customers, and then keep moving forward. Now, if you like this video, make sure to smash the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be notified when a similar video comes out next. Drop a comment below. Let me know what you think of this video and what is it that you want to hear next. Do not forget to share this video with your friends who might find this video useful. And with that being said, I'll see you in the next video.